Hello, hello, this is Panda, and today we will take a look at Minecraft World Seeds. When you create a Minecraft world, you can enter a seed for the world generation. The seed is a number which determines how the generated world will look. In theory, entering the same seed when creating a world will generate the exact same world all the time. This is mostly, but not completely true, but that's not what we will talk about today. Today we will take a look at how you can enter a seed. You got three options. Write a number, write a text, or write nothing. When writing a text, it will get translated into a number. To calculate the number, you start with a zero. Then you go through the letters from left to right, multiply the previous result by 31, and add the Unicode value of this letter. For example, let's try it with the text panda. We start with a zero, multiply it by 31, and add the Unicode value of a capital P, which is 80, so we get 80. Now we take that value, multiply it by 31 again, and add the Unicode value of a lowercase a, which is 97. So we will get 2577. We continue this pattern for n, d and a, so that there are no letters left, and voila, we have our result. For short texts, this manual method will work absolutely fine. However, for larger results, the calculation is bound by integer overflow. If you are interested in the details of that, please refer to the links in the description. But for now, it's enough for us to know that this means that the resulting number will always be a number from minus 2 point something billion to plus 2 point something billion. While that may sound like a lot of possible seeds, by this method you can only reach about 0.00000023% of all seeds. Instead of writing a text, you could also not enter a seed at all or write a zero into the seed field. In this case, a seed will get generated based on a time value in nanoseconds and how often random objects have been created before since you started Minecraft. So pretty much random. But due to the way the number is generated, this will produce one of about 280 trillion numbers. However, that's not simply the numbers counting up, but instead they are spread over a much wider range, with gaps of about 65,000 numbers in between them. Now, that's surely a lot of numbers. But it's still only about 0.0015% of all possible seeds. To get the vast majority of seeds, you will need to enter a number into the seed field. The valid numbers reach from about minus 9.2 quintillion to about plus 9.2 quintillion. All numbers that are smaller or greater than that will get interpreted as a text and handled as described before. You can reach 99.99 lots of 9% of all possible seeds when entering them as a number. In fact, the only seed you won't get this way is 0, as it will generate a random seed in this case. If you do want 0 as a seed, you can enter various texts that will evaluate to it though. So to sum it up, when you enter a text into the seed field, you will get one of a few billion of seeds. When you leave the seed field empty or enter 0 so that you get a random seed, you will get one of a few hundred trillion of seeds. And if you enter a number, you can choose out of 18 quintillion of seeds. If you want to see how your seed could have been generated, you can do so. Just follow the link in the description. The website will also calculate numbers for texts and texts that you could enter for a given number. On top of that, it also provides some additional information that I will talk about in future videos. As a last fun fact, in some really old versions of Java, random seeds would get picked based on the time in milliseconds since 1970. So if a Minecraft world would have been generated with a random seed in such a version of Java, you could tell the exact millisecond the world was generated merely by looking at the seed. It's really unlikely that this ever happens though, because these Java versions were already outdated long before Minecraft was released. Still, the link tool will also tell you about the theoretical generation time calculated from the seed. But that's it for now, thanks for watching, and see you next time! By the way, this is planned to be the first part in a series of videos about the Minecraft world generation. Before you get too excited, the uploads will be as infrequent as ever, so don't expect monthly videos or anything like that, you know I'm not that fast. But in some of the later episodes, I will explain ways to find good world seeds. And the plan is that the best technical seeds we found will be presented by Mary the Lapis Demon in a series on her channel. In case you don't know her yet, she got a mix of science, tech, art and creativity videos on her channel. I'm sure she will be able to present those seeds in a much nicer way than I would by just reading out some numbers. Don't expect it too soon, but when the series starts, I will link to it in the outro of this series. Bye!